You have to know who is your target group.
Okay, 第二步，这是第二环节了，蓝色，就是您的目标群体是谁。
Because you know this is a business opportunity.
您知道这个是这一个商机。
It is a really serious business opportunity.
这是一个非常一个专业的一个商机。
I wouldn't like to talk about 1, 2, 3, 5,000 US per month.
我不是说你可以赚到一二三或者是五个美金啊一个月。
You know, it's the MLM leader, it started 10,000 US per month.
通常就是直销的领导者就是至少会有一万美金的业绩。
This is the minimum limit.
这是他的就是我最少的那个那个标准。
So if you don't earn minimum 10,000 US per month, you are not a leader, actually.
所以如果您没有达到一万美金的那个业绩的话，您不是领导者。抱歉。
You're just a trier.
您只是一位很想要做一位商业者的一个人。
This is your trial period.
这是您的那个尝试期。
So, but of course, if you earn this minimum amount,
那当然，如果你可以赚
到这个 you have to see this is a business.
如果您可以赚到这个一万块的话，您就要把这个当作是一个很
就是商业。Things is not happening just ad hoc.
那当然，这个不是很突然，你想要做就做就会发生的一件事情。
You know, so we have to know who is your target group.
您一定要知道谁是您的顾客群呢。
You know, of course, you know you can take a question is everyone.
那当然，您的那个问你自己就是每个人吗
？Yes, of course.
是，那当然是每个人。
Everyone, because we never know who will be.Who will be the successful?
因为你不知道在每一个位人的当中，你不知道谁会成功。
I share with you many things from my previous life.
我我在这个前的第一个环节分享了好多东西。
So you know when I joined, I know many business people.
我在还没来到德信公司的时候，我已经认识了好多的商业人。
And of course, because my previous job, I was credible in front of them.
因为在我的之前的生意，对我来讲，我的那个就是每个人是可以相信我的这一个行业的人。
So I started to share the business.
所以我就在这个商业里面就开始了做一些分享。
Share my vision.
就可以讲一些我一个我的方向感。
Of course, most of the people told me, Laszlo, forget it. It's a really stupid idea.
就是说 ，Laszlo， 这是一个很笨的一个 idea。
Nobody would like to drink mushroom with coffee in Europe. It's not a good idea.
在欧洲里，没有人会要喝有蘑菇的咖啡啊。
And of course, few people say yes.
但是在那么多的人当中，有一些人说，这可能会发生的。
And I really remember a day when one person joined under me.
就是我记得有一天有一位就是作为我的会员。
It was an extremely successful businessman.
他是一位很非常成功的商人。
And he told me, yes, Laszlo, let's do it.
他就说 ，Laszlo， 我们一起做吧。
So I told myself, okay, Laszlo, your life is solved.
Oh, Laszlo, 你的生活已经解决了。
So do you know what happened?
你知道发生什么事吗
？Nothing happened.
没什么事情发生了。
Do you know who built under me the biggest turnover business?
你知道谁是最大的给我最大的业绩吗
？The simply bus driver.
一位巴士司机哦。
Simply bus driver.
就是巴士司机哦。
Because he was hungry.
因为他很饿。
He was hungry for the success.
因为他很渴望那个成功。
And he followed my guideline.
他完完全全听Mr. Laszlo 的那个解决方案。
So we never know who will be the successful.
你不知道谁可以成功。
Because this is a real business opportunity.
因为这一个是真实的一个商机。
Everybody can do this business.
每个人可以做到这一个商业。
So we have to share.This opportunity with everybody.
所以在你有机会的时候，你可以分享的这个商机，每个人你就可以分享。
I think this is the most important part today.
我觉得这一个是今天的很非常重要的一个重点。
Because of course, maybe you are here many years.
因为您在这里可能好多年了。
But I'm sure you don't know how does the MLM work.
但是可能你不知道完完全全直销是如何运作的。
So now I would like to tell you.
现在我就要告诉你。
So you are a serious person. You know everything.
您是一个非常积极的人，您要知道每一件事情。
And here is a new prospect.
他是不是我的一个新的一个可能的对象？
So now I'm doing my best.
所以我就做我最好的本分。
He's coming extremely excited.
我就是很兴奋的来到他面前。
Because I'm sharing everything perfectly.
因为他就是告诉我很诚恳的，全部的一五一十的告诉我的。
So inside his mind, yes, I can do it.
我就说可以，我可以做到。
This is the best opportunity for me.
这是对我来讲是一个非常非常良好的商机。
So he's extremely excited.
所以我就觉得哇，我非常兴奋。
But what is the next step?
但是下一个步骤呢？
He is going back to his home.
我就回家了。
And what happened in his home?
我在家干些什么呢？
His parents, his relatives, his friends.
我的父母，我的兄弟姐妹，我的身边朋友们。
Everybody will tell him it is a stupid idea.
你身边的人就说，好笨哦，你呢，这是一个，你被骗了，等等等等啊。
It is not working.
不可能可以运作的。
They already heard about it.
我们听过，听到不要听啦。
Somebody died with some mushroom.
有些人啊，吃蘑菇吃灵芝吃死。人啊、
They know many people who lost lots of money.
我就是你听到说，我们听到不有人说，
This is a
已经失去好多的金钱。
This is a money game. This is a pyramid scheme.
这是老鼠会啊，什么诈骗集团啊。
But the most important thing is.
但是重点是
，You cannot do it.
我不能做。
You are not a sales person. You cannot do it.
你不是销售人，你不能创，所以你更加不是一个创业者，不能做。
Yes, it's happening every time.
这是很现实的事情在发生着。
And you know, the it's really special things. They are who are talking about it. They are not wrong people. They are a nice person. Nice people.
就是我身边的人哦，他们告诉我的东西。他们不是坏人，他们是非常关心我、非常爱我的人啊。
They want the best for him.
他们就是为我好。
They want to save him.
他们要帮助我，不要我受骗啊。
But why happening?
但是为什么会发生呢？
Because they wasn't there when I talked with him.
因为我身边的人没有在场，在解，你是那时候解释的时候在场。
And they couldn't get real information.About this opportunity.
所以他们根本不能得到那个商机里面的那个资料以及精华。
So and of course he cannot save his decision.
所以我就不能拯救了我自己的决定。
So what can we do?
我可以怎样帮助他们呢？
Because it's happening every day.
因为每一天在发生的事情啊。
I cannot go back his home together with him.
Can you can? I talk to my mom. 对啊，你可以他不可以来到我的家就说告诉我父母，告诉我身边的人来解释啊。
But I'm sure this is one of the biggest challenges in the direct selling industry.
这是在直销的商业里面最大的挑战。
So what I'm doing every time?
所以我怎样的去为他们解决这个事情呢？
When we meet.
当我们在见面的时候。
当
我在很兴奋的见
他的时候 I only asked with him with you.
OK, 就是我们两位而已。
And I tell him
他会告诉我
What will happen when he arrives home.
他会让我知道当我回到家什么事情会发生。
So, honestly, I'm really direct. I tell him if you go back home, everybody will tell this.
那当然，如果回到家，这那样的事情会发生吗
？And I tell him, they are like you.
他们说他们不是讨厌你，他们疼你啊。
So no need to argue with them.
你不要跟他们争执啊，不要争吵啊。
j Just let them please come.
就是说，邀请他们过来，来，跟我来，跟随我来。
If they are serious about their thinking, please come and take this question to me.
如果他们真的是非常非常关心我，也担心我的话，就让他们带到他的面前，我会一五一十的告诉他们。
Or forget you and leave you to do this business. These two options.
不然我就让你自己去解决这些问题。
So don't worry about it.
不要担心。
It is available everywhere, every day.
因为这个是很家常便饭的事情。
But you have to handle it in the first meeting.
但是在第一个见面，你要先解决的这一个事情。
Of course, because this is a business opportunity, you have to do what is your product.
因为这个是一个商机，你要知道怎样去处理那一些这个商家的这个产品。
Every time I ask the expert member, what is your product?
就是说我问一些比较专业的那领导者说，您的那些您最喜欢用的产品是什么？
And they answer me, my product is a coffee.
我的产品我就是卖咖啡的。
The healthy coffee.
就是健康的咖啡啊。
The other one, my product is a freedom.
我另外的产品就是自由。
The passive income.
就是那个被动收入。
Of course, every answer is good.
每个他们有自己好的答案。
My product is different.
我的产品是也是不同的。
So when I meet first time in the new prospect.
那当然，如果我第一次见我的那个对象呢
？My main focus is.
我的专注点是。
End of the meeting.
在我们谈判的那个商业商部那个商机之后呢
？The new prospect has to feel I can do it.
那一个离开的时候，您的对象一定要觉得我可以办得到。
So my product is you can do this business too.
我的产品就是说我可以做到，您也可以做到。
This is what I am selling every time.
所以我每次就是卖，用这一个卖点来卖给人。
Of course, I talk about the coffee. I talk about this my why.
那当然我也是谈起我那个每次咖啡，而且提起我那个为什么。
Because why I use this way?
为什么我用这个方法呢
？Because my experience.
因为在我的经验。
If I meet the educated people.
如果我需要到那些很有高教育的人。
Who is open about the new opportunity?
对于这个商机有很大的开窍。
Of course, because everything is logically, he can understand. This is a good product. This is a stable company. This is a risky opportunity.
那当然，这个是一个好的产品，好的商家的背景，还有一个商机。
So he can accept everything.
如果他可以接受全部这些重点。
But of course, he cannot start this business if he cannot feel he can do it.
那当然，就是刚才像总裁说的，全部好，关我什么事啊？就是如果他觉得不能做，不能办得到，这也是等于零。
So my product is you can do this business.
所以我的卖点是您可以做到这一个商业。
So the next block I will share with you how can I do it.
下一个项目环节就是我教你们就是怎样，您怎样做到。
And you know the other thing, I think it is a big misunderstanding. Do most of the people think they have to convince the people?
很多人呢，在直销方面，直销的商业里面，我们一定要说服他们呐、说服他们。
No, this is an information sharing business.
对不起，抱歉，一个是提供信息的一个生意。
I wouldn't like to convince anybody.
我不喜欢说服人的。
If somebody drinks different coffee, this is not my problem. This is their problem.
如果我已经提倡了这个理智咖啡是非常有益的，如果他不买，这是他的问题，不是我的问题。
Somebody cannot understand how big this opportunity. It is not my problem.
如果他也不能体会到这个是一个商业的一个商机，也不是我的问题。
It is his problem.
这是他的问题。
So I don't worry about it.
所以我根本对这件事情无所谓。
My job is the information sharing. That's it.
我的本分就是把我的这些信息传出去，就是这样而已。
I share my why.
我也解释了，我也分享了关于我的为什么，
My vision,
我的目标。
And somebody accepted it is good.
如果在当中有人接受，那非常棒啊。
Somebody not, it is not my problem.
如果也没有接受的话，也无所谓。
Okay, so I teach the members one really important attitude.
我就是要教你们一个很好的那个那个态度，对态度。
I have nothing to lose.
我没有什么可以失去的方法。
Okay, I will share with you what I mean about it.
我现在解释什么像我所说的意思。
So you are here.
你住在那个人那边。
This is your level.
这是您的水平。
I mean your level. You know, this is your turnover level.
就是您的那个点点点的，就是您的那个业绩。
So you have a work, you already have a turnover, you have a customers who buy the products, you have a team.
你已经有自己的那个顾客群。
And you need the new prospect.
你要新的对象。
You know, you have two options after the meeting.
您有两个那个选择，就是在那个我们见面的时候那个选择。
This person join under you or not?
这位人会跟随您吗
？No more option.
没有别的选择了。
Or I can say this person buy something or not.
不然就是 OK， 他没有成为您的会员，没成为您下线，就是他会跟你买吗
？So only these two options.
就是这两个。
But what happening if these people, if this person doesn't buy anything, he doesn't want to join?
那当然，如果他两个都不做呢？
What happening? Nothing.
就是什么都不，你什么都没发生啊。
You will be the same level.
你还会在同样的水平。
So until today, this person never bought anything from you.
到今天的话，如果各位人还没有买一样产，未向你买一样产品的话
，So you cannot lose anything.
你觉得你会损失什么吗
？If you met a new prospect, you can only win.
如果已经找到一个新的商业对象，您是赢家。
So from your part, two options.
在你的本分有两个刚才所提的项目。
You win a new customer or leaders.
您会赢到一位新的顾客或者是领导者。
Or you are staying the same level.
不然就是你就是在原地，在于您的这个水平上，您根本没有输。
So you cannot lose anything.
你根本没有失去什么的。
So if you accept this type of attitude, this type of approach,
如果您可以接受这一个想法的态度
，you can be happy.
你可以很有喜乐的去耕耘这个事业的。
Every meeting a new opportunity for you.
每个您见面的每一位就是一个新的商机啊。
But you cannot lose anything.
你根本没失去什么。
You know.I many times realize it, you know, when the people meet a new prospect, you know, they are really scared, they are really afraid. It's what will happen.
很多那些人就是在找新的顾客、找新的顾客对象的时候，他们会很慌、很怕。喂。
But if you use this type of attitude, you will be different.
如果换你的角度，用这个态度来看，你就会没事了。
I cannot lose anything.
我根本没失去什么。
Maybe I got a new experience.
但是，我还有学到新的东西，是新的经验。
Okay, so see the opportunity in everyone.
在每一个人身上，一定要看到这一个机会。
Okay, because we never know who will be the successful.
因为我们根本不知道未来是怎样的哈。
Okay, so I just want to share with you the story.
现在我要再分享多一个故事。
You know, one time the really old person.
有一位老先生。
Who was really sick.
Sick. 很非常病得很蛮严重的。
Just try the product.
就是试了这产品。
Of course, nobody can believe these people can be the leader.
就是没有人可以相信他们，他可以作为一个领导者。
Because he just want to survive.
因为他只是要活下去。
He just use the product.
他就用这个产品。
He doesn't know what is the MLM.
他根本不知道这家公司是什么。
He doesn't know the company name.
他根本不知道那个这家公司叫什么名。
Just use the product.
就是用了产品。
But what happened?
发生，然而呢
？One day, his neighborhood realized on the table the Ganoderma.
有一天，就是他的那个邻居们就发现到那朵莲子。
And asked him, "What is this?"
就说那个是什么呢？
Share, I got it. It is really good.
不知道，就是我吃了，我好了。
But it was really interesting for the neighborhood.
就是在那个邻居的那个左邻右舍的人就觉得哎，就启发了一些事情。
So he asked who bring here this product.
说这个产品，那个标号有一个灵芝是谁带来的
？And after he joined.
然后他就
under 46 people
就已经有那位人就在那个病者下面就做了，成为他的下线了。
And he opened a new country.
他就是开启了一个新的国家的市场。
So we never know.
我们根本不知道。
With who is it the easiest?
找哪一种人是最容易，或者是最适合的
？Of course, you know, everybody would like to know what is the easiest way.
很多人我们喜欢比较容易、比较简单的事情去做嘛，对吗
？My experience is the easiest way.
我的经历呢，就是最简单的或者最容易的的方式呢。
The person who is hungry for the success, not、就是、for the money, not only the money, hungry for the success.
就是他们呢。就渴望，不单只是渴望金钱，但是也渴望那个成功感。
Okay, so not interesting. How is the background?
至于那位人的那个背景，并不重要。
How is the age?
那个岁数年龄不重要。
How is the experience?
他的人生经历不重要。
The interesting thing is
最重要的是
how is hungry somebody.
他现在至于他的心是多么可的渴望。
So you have to find the hungry people.
所以你要找那些比较饿的人。He's from hungry, so he's always hungry. Okay.
And of course, you know, it is, it's our situation is really, really lucky because we know many coffee drinkers.
那当然好处是我们已经很庆幸了，因为我们身边人一定喝咖啡的。
And the coffee drinkers knows other coffee drinkers.
那当然，喝咖啡，他身边的朋友也是喝咖啡的。
So the market is unlimited.
所以那个市场的那个广范围是非常广。
The other key point is in this business.
就是下一个重点就是
，When we talk about the new prospect.
当你在对跟那个商业对象在谈起生意的时候
，They have to know it is worth for them.
你一定要知道，在他们的角度，这个产品是对他们是值得的。
You know, everybody has a different push button.
每个人都有不同的那个推动一点。
It's really funny things. We every time try to talk about the money.
你每一次去见到人说，哎呀，赚钱要赚钱，你可以来赚钱。
But not money, the most important thing.
但是对有些人来说，金钱在他们生活不是最重要的。
So different people, different push button.
每个人有不同的推动力。
But you know, my goal is when I selling this opportunity.
当我的目标就是每当我在把这个商机在传销出来的时候呢。
The new prospect has to understand this is worth for him.
他一定要感觉到哦，这个产品或者这个商机对我来说是非常值得的。
Because you have to be sure.
因为你要非常肯定的。
If somebody tell you it's not interesting for me.
如果那个对象跟你说对不起，我没兴趣的话
，It is not calling for you. It is not calling for you. It is not calling for the company. Not calling for the opportunity.
就是不是就是那个回应不是因为那个公司。
He's calling it. He cannot understand how worse it for him.
因为他看不到那个，这个时候，那位您的对象他还看不到那个我们所说的那个价值，对他来说的那个价值观。
I promise to you.
但是我可以给你一个承诺。
I will show you it's how can you show the people who cannot imagine they can do this business.
我可以教你们，就是说他们那些根本不能可以相信他们可以做这门生意的话。我可以教你们怎样去开窍他们。
I really enjoy this part.
我非常喜欢这一个项目。
So you know my product is, you can do this business.
我的产品就是您也可以做到这个商业计划。
But most of the people say, no, I cannot do this business.
很多人说根本不能做到的这本生意。
So I have to show them you you can do this business.
但是我的责任就是，我就是摊开给你们说，就说，哎，你可以做到的。
So I'm really lucky because I know the product is working.
我感觉到很庆幸，就是因为我已经知道这个产品是可以工作的。
Every time I'm telling it.
所以每一次我是会强调这一点。
Now I would like to show you, you can do this business.
现在我会告诉你们，你也可以做到这一门生意。
No need it, trust me.
你
No, sorry.
你不一定要100%来信我哦。
Trust your own experience. Trust your own experience.
你现在听了就好，你要相信你自己的本身的经历。
Just try this method and let's see what is the result.
Okay, 先试一试这个产品，然后你看一看那个结果成绩是怎样的， okay. 就行了。
So, here is the box of coffee.
这一包咖啡。
And next time when you go your workplace.
下一次如果你到你的办公室，工作的办公室。
Please don't talk about this business opportunity.
千万不要在他们面前提起这个商机。
Please don't talk about the product.
不要在他们面前，在你办公室说，啊，这个产品很好很好很好。
Just usually open the such a coffee and drink it.
就是带你的咖啡到你的办公室去喝就行了。
What will happen?
这样就发生什么事呢？
Maybe in the first day, maybe in the first week.Your colleagues will ask you, "What is this?"
可能您带的咖啡，您的那个同事就会开始遇到，哎，你带的那个是什么咖啡啊？
Because you are drinking in front of them.
因为你在他们面前喝。
But you don't talk anything.
你什么都不说。
Just drink.
就是喝。
So few days later, he will ask, "What is this? Why you are drinking this coffee?"
再过多几天，又有人在你的同事就说，这是什么？什么咖啡？为什么你要喝这个咖啡啊？
And that point is really important. Please don't switch on your presentation mode and take the product catalog and talking 1 hour presentation. How amazing this opportunity! Forget it.
你千万不要它这个是最重要的重点哦。你不要突然间摊开你的那个你要讲解的那个 slide presentation 去讲解。千篇一律的去讲解这个关于咖啡的好处，不要这样做。
Just answer the question.
回答他们的问题就行了。
I drink this coffee because I had a stomach problem and this coffee is finished.
我喝这个咖啡，我以前有胃痛，所以我喝了这个咖啡，我的胃疼已经好了。
Just the true things.
就是分享真实的事情。
I drink this coffee because this is my personal prevention.
我喝这个咖啡，就是因为这个对我来讲是一个抗病的一个方法。
Because it's not simple. The coffee is coffee, the healthy mushroom.
因为这个不是普通的咖啡，这是一个发酵的咖啡，里面含有一些灵芝。
I drink this coffee because one of my friends suggests to me, and my friend has a problem, and this coffee is solved. So this is why I drink.
为什么我会喝呢？就是因为我之前我的朋友也是有一些健康的问题，所以他介绍了这个咖啡给我，所以他。我喝了这个咖啡，我的健康问题就没了。
Just answer the question.
就是什么都不讲，就是回答
到底是什么。Don't sell anything.
不要卖。
What will happen?
接下来的事情会发生怎样发生呢？
Most of the time, this answer will be interesting for them.
通常您的答案是会激发他们的好奇心的。
Not the MLM, not the coffee.
不是因为咖啡，也不是因为是直销。
The benefit，
但是那个产品里面的好处，
the
benefit, 那个好处对他们来讲是他最喜欢的。
And they want to buy.
他们就会要买了。
And this is the plan.
这就是直销。
Don't trust me, please try it.
你不相信吗？你去办公室去开一包咖啡，在他们面前喝。
You know, many people come back to me.
很多人就会回到来我这里。
That's why it is working.
那是，这成了。
Welcome to the direct selling business.
欢迎来到直销领域。
You can do it. This is the real direct selling business.
这个才是真实的直销做生意方式。
They can do the same.
他们也可以做同样东西。
You know, when I started to use this method.
当我用这个方法来做这个商业的时候。
few people come back to me.
有些人回来，来我面前。
That's so sorry, I cannot do it.
他说对不起，我做不到，办不到。
Because I have a job.
因为我有自己的事业。
So I cannot be in front of my colleagues.
所以我就不能在我的那个同事面前喝咖啡。
Okay, so I told them.No worry.
所以说没关系 ，OK 啊，给他听。
Next time when you go together with your friend to the coffee shop,
你不要在办公室。如果下一次你再跟你朋友出去外面游玩的时候
，Just do one thing.
做一件事。
Please order a cup of hot water.
在咖啡馆或者在外面吃的餐馆，叫一杯热水就行了。
And drink your own coffee.
能带你自己的咖啡。
Don't talk anything.
什么都不说。
If you go to the summer lunch together with your family,
如果您在有一个野餐，跟你家人的野餐
，your mom house for example,
可能你去到您的或者岳母或者是你的亲家的家庭。
And you know after the lunch they ask it, somebody ask some coffee. After the lunch somebody ask.Somebody
okay, okay, okay. 那当然，吃完的时候，通常他们会问，谁要喝咖啡啊
？Just ask the cup holder.
你就说我要热水而已。
You have to be sure they will ask why you order only a hot water.
他们就会问，每个人要咖啡，为什么你只要一杯热水
？And don't switch presentation mode.
也别再变去你要讲座的那个讲师哈。
No need to show the product catalog.
不要再打开翻开那个您的那个产品的这个书本哦。
Just answer the question.
回答他们问题就行了。
You know, some people is come back to me.
有些人又会回来告诉我。
That's why I have a problem.
那是我有些少许的问题。
I never go to the coffee shop with my friend.
我根本没有与我的朋友去咖啡馆啊。
My relative never invited me Sunday.
我的家人根本没有邀请我去他们的聚会。
What can I do?
我可以做什么呢？
So I share with you is how I work in my house.
Okay, 在我的家庭当中，我怎样去办，怎样去做这个事业
？So for example, William come to my house.
William 去到拉斯的家。
He doesn't know anything about the Ghana
one. 我对灵芝对咖啡什么都不理解。
So I ask him, would you like to drink a coffee?
他就会问我，你要喝一杯咖啡吗
？And then he say yes.
我说哦，当然。
My wife bring me a cup of hot water.
那他太太就会端一杯咖啡给我，一杯热水。
And serve me a normal coffee.
就是给我一杯普通的咖啡。
And I don't talk anything.
他什么都不说。
But of course, William will ask me, Laszlo, which type of coffee do you drink?
Laszlo, 你喝的是哪一种的种类的咖啡啊
？Why do you drink different coffee?
为什么你喝这个有点不一样的咖啡呢
？And answer.
您就要老实的回答就行了。
So please don't trust me.
如果你不相信，如果那当然你不一定要相信我所说的话。
Just try it.
去尝试一下，做个试验。
And trust your own experience.
然后再尝试你自己本身的经历。
Okay. So of course, you know, it is a risk-free opportunity.
那当然，重点是这个是一个没有风险的一个商机。
But you can take a risk for yourself if you use the wrong way.
那当然，如果你把自己你做错了那个方式，您就会把自己放在一个有那个冒险的那个状况。
What is the wrong way?
什么是不对的方式
？If you buy many boxes of coffee,
如果你买到差不多很多包的咖啡
，and just share it such and such and。
然后你一包一包的小小包的拆散去卖的话
，No, just give the one such as the friends, please try it.
试一试啊，来试一试啊，就试一试啊。
So first of all, because it's a gift, it is not valuable.
第一，因为它是礼物，所以它没有那个价值在那边。
The other issue is somebody try one such a coffee, they can feel okay, it is a coffee.
那当然，如果是试了那咖啡，觉得 OK， 这个咖啡就是咖啡啊。
But they cannot feel the difference.
他们不能感觉到那个不同的那个感受。
They cannot feel the benefit.
他们不能体会到那个给他们健康上的那个好处。
So my experience in somebody is up to 40.
如果我的经验是，如果他们是
up to 40. 40 years old.
我的经历就是对于那些40岁的人。
And he drinks one box coffee.
他喝了一包咖啡之后
，He has to feel the different.
他一定要有感觉到有不同的地方。
If somebody is older, can feel faster.
人比较年纪比较老的话，就他的经历就可能比较时间会比较短一点，比较快。
But it's somebody is young, of course. I'm sorry.They cannot because they are too young.
那当然，如果他们很年轻的话，可能那个经历、那个体会到的不同，可能他没有那么多了，没有那么大的差别。
You know, the body is more healthy.
为什么呢？因为年轻的人大致上是比较健康。
Less toxin inside.
毒素比较少嘛，
okay.
对吧
？So how is my method?
我的方法就是。
So of course, here is a box of coffee. I would like to sell to you.
就是他就是把一包咖啡要卖给我。
Of course, if I want to sell it, you wouldn't like to buy it.
如果那当然他要卖，我不想买啊。
Because the people is really hate when somebody want to sell something.
就是我们看得太多了，就是我就是不喜欢他卖东西给我嘛。
So I learned a really simple techniques.
他就是学到了一个很简单的一个方法。
Don't trust me, just try it.
再强调一下。不要相信他，去尝试一下。
So this is the box of coffee.
这是一包咖啡。
And you need.
然后我们见面了。
I talk about it. Why I drink this coffee because you ask it.
他告诉我就是我为什么他喝咖啡，因为是我自己已经问过拉斯说为什么他喝这个咖啡。
But I wouldn't like to give you one such a coffee because this is not good.
他不想就是把那一包给我，因为就他觉得不对，
so、
不好。
So I take this box.
他就拿这一包咖啡。
I tell you,
他就告诉我
I'm sure this coffee is good for me.
我很肯能肯定的，这包咖啡对他来说是有很大的好处。
And you know this is a risk-free opportunity.
这个第二就是这个是一个很没有risk 风险的一个商机。
So now I give you this whole box. Whole box. Give me.Yes.
Give. Okay. 他就把这个咖啡给了我。
And no need to pay now.
现在你不用付我钱。
This box of coffee, I don't know how many ringgit here.
The quantity of coffee is 35. New coffee is 33.
Okay. This is 33 ringgit.
33 ringgit 就是那个黑咖啡就是33零几。
But no need.
马币。
No need to pay now.
不用付33零几给他。
I have one request.
我有一个小请求。
Please drink only this coffee.
求求你，只是喝这个咖啡。
So please don't drink any other coffee during this box is
open. So 这个时候你在开始喝这咖啡，什么咖啡都不要喝，先喝完这个咖啡。
And please don't share anybody.
不要跟人分享啊，自己喝哈。
So please drink this 20 such a coffee.
这里面一包里面有20小包的咖啡，你喝完它。
And if it is not good for you.
如果你觉得不好啊
！Please bring back the empty box.
您拿回那个空盒、空包给我。
And if it is good for you, you can pay when you are finished.
如果您觉得这个对你身体有好、非常很大的改善，你就可以付我那笔钱33.7哦。
Now you think maybe it is a risk.
您觉得可能这个是一个风险哦。
But I share with you how working the human mind.
这个就是一个我们的一个心理学哈。
If I say William, please buy this one box coffee 35 ringgit. He say no, I wouldn't like to buy it.
那如果很在传统方面，如果拉斯他接他来告诉我，来 William, 你买33元的咖啡，我不会买的。
But if I give him and tell him, please ask if you are satisfied and call later.
他就说，他先把那咖啡交给我，我喝完了，看我对这个咖啡满意吗
？But because he's human, he start to thinking.
因为我是人，所以我会想。
What happening now?
在我的身体在发生了什么事
？Laszlo thinking, I haven't 35 ringgit for one box coffee.
Laszlo 已经的，他说给我35，把我给我了一个35元的一包咖啡。
Laszlo thinking I cannot pay 35 ringgit now.
Laszlo 觉得我没有能力付起那个35零几吗
？Of course, 35 is nothing. I want to pay now.
35零几我当然付得起啊。
it is not a big deal.
这不是大问题啊。
Okay, so please don't trust me. Please try it.
所以你不相信，来做一个试验吧。
You know, most of the people want to try pay immediately.
很多在很多的这个当中，很每个人是差不多马上会付钱给你的。
Because you don't sell.
因为你不是很刻意的去卖。
Of course, few people will accept.
那当然。有几个人会这样接受了吗
？But in my experience, nobody run away with my certified payment.
那些人呢，就是不会拿走他那包三十五零七的咖啡，然后就走掉了。
Okay, so please try it.
I will. Okay. I mean, I will run away.
Okay, so please try it.
Okay, 尝试哈。
So no need to sell.
不要刻意的去卖。
Just share this idea.
就是分享这一个理念就可以了。
So, you can give the opportunity to the people. They can try it. They can do this business.
就测试一下，看看你是否能做到，他们能不能做到。
Just ask the hot water.
就是拿一杯热水。
Don't talk about the business.
什么不说。
And the people will ask, what is this?
让人家问你这一个是什么产品，这是什么生意。
And this is the real multi-level marketing business.
这就是一个纯正的直销的商业方式。